again. But wait, do you know what a floss is? If not, don't worry, I've made a small video on dental floss. The link to that video will be given in the description below, or you can click on the link here to watch that video. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Arif Deshmukh. Welcome if you're new to the channel, and welcome back everyone else. The number one reason why people don't use dental floss is because they don't know how to use it. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the dental floss the right way. So we'll start with the dental floss. What you need to do is you need to make sure that you have around 15 to 18 inches of dental floss in your hand. Then you need to wrap the dental floss on the middle fingers of both of your hands and make sure that around 2 to 5 inches of dental floss is still remaining. Then you need to make sure that your index finger and your thumb are holding the dental floss in a pinch grip. So this is the most important part of using a dental floss. Then once you have this grip, it makes it much more easier to use the dental floss. Before starting on how to use it, I'll tell you how not to use the dental floss. You should not put the dental floss like this and take it out immediately. It's of no use. What you need to do is you need to make sure that you need to put the dental floss in a wiggle manner. So you have to put a little force and use the dental floss in a wiggle manner so that it reaches the gum line. Once it reaches the gum line, make sure that you are using very less pressure not to hurt the gums. Okay, then you have to also make sure that the dental floss, it goes inside the gum line, okay, something like this. Then once it goes inside the gum line, you need to make sure that you wrap the dental floss around the tooth, more like embrace the tooth, okay, like this. Once you do that, you need to use a little bit of up and down motion to remove the plaque. And without removing the dental floss from this area, you need to change sides to like this. Okay, so if you were cleaning like this, then the next second you need to change it to this side, and again do the up down motions and then take it off. Okay, if any food particle is stuck here, you need to use water to clean it, or you can use another part of the dental floss. Okay, then one more method is to use a floss pick. Floss picks are basically flosses with handles, and they can easily go and help you maneuver. The only disadvantage I feel is that you cannot wrap the floss around the tooth, which you can with a normal dental floss. But the technique is the same. A little bit of wiggle. Make sure it reaches the gum line. Up down motion. Change sides. Up down motion. Take it out. Okay. And there are times where even the floss pick is difficult to use, like the molar teeth. So for that, we can use a modified floss pick, which is a little angular in design. So this is a conventional floss pick and this is an angular floss pick. So what this will help you is when you're flossing the posterior teeth, you know, you just need to, if this is the way you're going to enter your mouth to floss, just go behind and wiggle reach the gum line, up down motion, change side, up down motion, take it out. It seems hectic, but once you know the technique of using a floss, it makes it much more easier, and even the whole process of using a floss becomes quite faster. Flossing is an important pillar in promoting good oral hygiene. I understand it's a little technique sensitive, and due to which there have been recent advancements like the interdental brushes, the electric flossers and the water flossers, the videos of which are coming soon on this channel, so consider subscribing. And that's it for today. Do give a like if you found this video a little helpful, and I'm waiting to talk to you guys in the comment section below, and please stay safe out there.